Welcome everyone. Here we discuss about electron affinity. First of all, what is electron affinity? Electron affinity of an element is defined as the amount of energy released when an electron is added to the valence shell of an isolated gaseous atom of that element to convert the atom into gaseous ionic-negative ion, that is anion. X is the isolated gaseous atom. If we added an electron to convert the atom into gaseous ionic-negative ion, that is anion, the released energy is the electron affinity. Electron affinity values are expressed in electron volt per atom, kilocalorie per mole, and kilojoule per mole. Factors affecting the magnitude of electron affinity. First is size of the atom. The smaller is the size of the atom, the greater is the electron affinity. That is, electron affinity increases when size decreases. Second is nuclear charge. Electron affinity is directly proportional to the nuclear charge. When nuclear charge increases, electron affinity increases. That is, electron affinity varies nuclear charge. Third is electron configuration. Atoms with stable electronic configuration, that is half filled or full filled, have little or no tendency to accept electron. So they have low or negative electron affinity values. Tendency to attain stable electronic configuration is reflected by the high electron affinity values. Periodic trend of electron affinity. Variation in a period. On moving from alkali metals to halogen in a period, the size of the atom decreases and the nuclear charge increases. Both these factors increases the force of attraction between the nucleus and the electron being added, and hence the atom has a greater tendency to attract the electron towards itself. Thus, the electron affinity values go on increasing generally when we move from left to right along a period. That is, this is the left to right along a period. When we move, the electron affinity values increases. This is the general trend. Now, variation in a group. On moving down a group, both the size of the atom and the nuclear charge increases. The increase in atomic size tends to decrease the electron affinity values, while the increase in nuclear charge tends to increase the electron affinity values. The net result is that the effect produced by the progressive increase of the atomic size outweighs the effect produced by the progressive increase in nuclear charge, and consequently the electron affinity values goes on decreasing as we move from top to bottom in a group. Important information about electron affinity. First, the noble gas atom has stable NH2-NP6 electron configuration. Except helium, helium has 1s2 configuration. They have no tendency to accept any more electron, therefore their electron affinity values are negative. The outermost shell of noble gases are completely filled, that is NH2 NP6, and in case of helium it is 1H2. Therefore, they have no tendency to accept any more electron and their electron affinity values are negative. Second, the valence shell of halogen atoms are one electron short of the next noble gas atom. So, to attain stable electronic configuration, they have very high tendency to accept one electron. Accordingly, they possess high positive electron affinity values. The general electron configuration of halogen atoms are NH2 NP5. So, they have one electron short to attain the noble gas electron configuration, that is NH2 NP6 for noble gases. So, the halogen atom have very high tendency to accept one electron and they possess high electron affinity values. Third, beryllium and magnesium have filled S shell. Outer electronic configuration of beryllium is 2H2 and outer electronic configuration of magnesium is 3H2. That is, their S shell are filled. And nitrogen has half filled P shell. Outer electronic configuration of nitrogen is 2H2, 2P3. That is, 2P3 is half filled. According to Hund's rule, a half-filled or full-filled shell attains extra stability. Hence, the atoms concerned would be much reluctant to accept extra electron. Their electron affinity values are negative accordingly. Fourth, the lower electron affinity value of fluorine than chlorine is due to its small size, that is, size of fluorine is very small, very high charge density, the charge density of fluorine is very high, very strong repulsion between the non-bonding electron and the entering electron. Again, the bond energy of F2 is less than that of Cl2, which indicates that fluorine atom will capture an electron less firmly than will the chlorine atom. That is, electron affinity of the fluorine will be the lower. Now, one problem in electron affinity. The electron affinity of chlorine is 349 kilojoule per mole. How much energy in kilojoule is released when 1 gram of chlorine is converted completely into Cl- ions in the gaseous state? Answer is, amount of energy released when 35.5 gram of chlorine are converted into chlorine minus ion is equal to 349 kilojoule per mole. Amount of energy released when 1 gram of chlorine is converted into chlorine minus ions are 349 by 35.5 kilojoule per mole, that is 9.83 kilojoule per mole. Thank you.